in the neck on East 183rd Street following a dispute. He was later pronounced dead at St. Barnabas Hospital.
My brother was 15. He was a boy.
A wake was held for the second day. Junior's mother greeted by the crowd with a bouquet of white flowers.
Dios te bendiga.
Mayor de Blasio arrived later, along with several young NYPD explorers, a group Guzman Feliz was a part of, hoping to one day become a police officer.
So, this is your brother Herman Smalls, trying to bring you live and direct the people that are here to pay their respects to this young man. Ran into a longtime friend from the Bronx and also a brother whose life has had issues that I think relate to some of the things going on today. We were just going into a great build. And I said, good brother, can we share some of this wisdom you got? And at first he was reluctant, but he thanked me and blessed me as he's relenting. So what your name, your history, what can you share? What are some of these young men going through today?
Well, how you doing? I'm from Harlem. Basically. A lot of people know me. And it's just sad though how this gang mentality is now. It's developed by these penitentiaries, and these kids now just something else to jump on other kids and stab them. And then, I mean, really, this is a very hurting feeling. And it seems like there's no end to this. I don't even know how you can combat this kind of situation now with these young kids coming up with this gang mentality. It's just so sad. And like I said, I know a lot of people that did a lot of time, 34 years in penitentiaries, and we look at these young kids saying, these kids is off the chain now, they're crazy. And get to a point, we're scared of them. We're scared of them to a point that they can cause us to go back to these penitentiaries for things that we don't want to go back.
Right, you know,
exactly. We all live in the same community, we come from the same, don't have nothing, and we fight against things like that. We need to fight against things like gentrification, how the system is doing us.
Right.
And we don't have jobs and no place to live, kids.
And also, I want to explore like that fear for a moment, because a lot of people get that twisted. Like you said, it's a fear, because you know, you brothers, I know the OGs know what you're capable of. The fear is going back in the joint. It's not the fear of them per se, but knowing that they have no rules and boundaries to check them, you might have to do something that will have you back
of
inside
course,
the joint.
First of all, I want to say rest in peace, Junior. I am happy that the five people that are behind your murder are arrested. And I just want to be honest, I think jail is too good for them, but they gonna get theirs at the end of the day. I believe that strongly. The crazy thing is shit like this happens all the time where we come from. And then this was a case of mistaken identity, which makes it sad, but I'm more mad than sad. You have to understand that I seen this video like 60 different angles because everybody's on their fucking cell phone trying to get a video. Are you really out there trying to get some likes over somebody dying? Like, and then the store owners, he got beat up. He got dragged out of the store. Nobody helped him. They jumped his ass. They stabbed him. He came back in the store and still nobody was like, tried to help him. They even kicked him out as he was bleeding. So everybody in that fucking store can kiss my black ass. They need to burn that bitch down. And for those men that's behind this, I'm glad your ass is going to prison. Because once you get in there, I want you to try that on a grown ass man. The whole jail gonna end up running a train on you with your dumb ass.
Yo, that was a baby, motherfucker. That was a baby. You fucking asshole. I hope you ride it back inside that.
So I'm making a statement, me, Jakim Diaz, and what I'm gonna do from this point on. Today, I saw a lady, she took a loss, and I helped her, and I gave her words of encouragement until she stood again, until I walked to where she needed to be. So I gave out my own energy to help my neighbor. People mention the Bible. People mention religion and all of this. And one single underlying connection between them all is love and honor thy neighbor.
All of them say that.
So then what's the problem? There's so many churches in the U.S. state that if you took a homeless person and put it in every church, you will end homelessness tomorrow.
Teach.
So we are disunified and broken, and that's why we haven't come together. Social organizations, churches, religious groups, Muslims, Jews, Hindus, atheists, gays, every group, I don't care who you are. You are subjected to talk about the issues that is pervaded in destroying our neighborhoods collectively, period, collectively. So the next call to action, so there's so many gangs rapping in the hood, I have strong brothers. My strong brothers don't like what they've been seeing. So we've been talking and dialoguing. And I had many dialogue with gang members, and I know that half of them are undereducated, they can't read, they are hurt, they got backgrounds, they got shit they going through. So we're gonna mobilize some strong brothers and some people, and we're gonna march through these hoods, and any gang member, and I'm saying this now, we got something to talk about. Because if you're gonna oppress my people too, then you are part of this oppressive system, and I'm sticking it to the man, so I need to stick it to you too.
That's right.
It's a problem. So that's immediate action.
We are the originals what started gangs back in the day. All right? I've got three of the elders who's been presidents of the Black Spain, the peacemakers and everything since the 60s. Why we was a gang then? Because we took care of our community. You could come in our community and do nothing without speaking to somebody from that organization. And this is what we want to give the community back. We got to stop being together and not let nobody come in your community and hurt your child. Rob your elder. Slap some lady down because she got a new phone. We got to start being together as people. I don't care you Dominican. I don't care you Puerto Rican. I don't care you Haitian. I don't care you African. We are all human beings living here.
Ashe.
I've been on 183rd since 1969. All right? We are part of the reason why you hear people scream, what's the word? 183rd, right? We started that.
That's right.
We the ones who brought that about. We the ones who gave these kids that's running around the credit that they have now. Because the way we did it, we party, we celebrate it, we do block parties, we do rent parties to help people don't lose their apartment. We used to chip in to get the trucks to come on the block with the slide thing for the kids. We did things to make the community safe. Ain't nobody doing that no more. You know why they don't want that no more? Because then that's unity. Mm. When we was able to kick open our light pole and plug up our speakers in our system, we was able to bring everybody together and enjoy life.
Mm.
Right. And respect each other.
I say.
Me and Primo sit there, play dominoes, drink best sound like what? We family.
That's right.
Because
right.
We live here. We gotta take care of each other.
Exactly.
We always wanna blame them.
Exactly.
They gonna never be there on time.
Exactly.
Only us.
Exactly.
We're the only one that can be on time to stop something. Because we live here. We live here. We gotta make a difference.
That's right.
And the only difference is we gotta push all this away. We gotta push colors, everything away.
That's right.
We gotta protect each other. We gotta love each other, man. And the whole key is respect.
Respect.
As long as we give respect, we're gonna have peace.
Yes.
How will we guide them if we keep that barrier between us?
I mean, it's hard. Yeah, to be honest, that's the thing that's real scary. I don't even know nothing to combat the situation with them, to be honest. You know what I mean? Maybe we need to get some of these big celebrities to play a part, like LeBron James, whoever, to come in this community and talk to these kids. That could probably help if they actually see these people that they look up to them and actually see them and reach out to them and talk to them. Things like that. Then you got some kids They just can't be talked to, man. That's I'm sad to say, that's why they build penitentiary. Some people are just so out of control, they can't live in society, it seems like, at times. Mm-hmm. You understand what I'm trying to say? And it's just, it's a hurting feeling, though, because, like, we all have kids, and our kids are subjected to this. I don't want to have a kid to grow up to be part of this thing, but, you know, this gang mentality, like I always tell people, we had gangs growing up, too, when we was growing up. The difference with these gangs bother innocent people, you're not even bothering them. Mm-hmm. And when you bother people that's not bothering you, and attack them, you're gonna have a problem in the system, mm-hmm. always.
I even hear some of the initiations have to deal with randomly causing acts, whether it's a slashing or some kind of physically brutal act, just to prove that you're worthy to be in the gang. That seems to be one of the codes they're applying.
Yes, it is, and that is so sad.
Mm-hmm.
But you attack somebody, don't have nothing, never did nothing to you, nothing mm-hmm. like that. I'm mm-hmm. totally against that. They use that same energy and go against the system, like I said, with gentrification, get a place to live, jobs. Have that. We're fighting each other. We're not the enemy. We all know this American system is the enemy to us. It puts
Speed,
us in this
teach,
situation.
Teach.
So, you really need to be honest. That caused these kids. Don't have nothing to do. No community, no centers, no places to go. They get the wrong people in the ear, and they follow behind these things. They put batteries in their back, and they go do crazy stuff. And then 40 years, when they look back, and their whole life has been in that penitentiary, it's just sad, though. It's just so sad mm-hmm. how this, the world that we come to. These kids here, like I said, what makes this real dangerous, I don't even know what to say to combat this situation.
Mm-hmm.
And really, to be honest, I don't even know how to change this situation with half these kids, man.
Well, I tell you, I think a good place always to start is to hear them, you know, listen to them, provide an ear, because they're going through many things that are having a face on. A lot of them are scared. This is fear. The gangs order to, you know, people are rolling on me. I need a force. Who can I roll with so I can defend myself? So many of these actions are fear-based. I think, again, as men, as we either stay in or get back into the home and make sure that these young men coming up behind us have some kind of structure. So all is not lost yet, but we are in a dire situation.
And the situation, like I said, what's real sad too, you can try to talk to some of these kids will jump on you now for trying to give them good advice.
Mm.
That's what makes it so sad. They jump on old people. I seen 3 or 4 kids jump on a 7-year-old man. You see it every day. Mm-hmm. It's just so sad. They jump on old people. You give them advice. What you looking at? Shut up. And jump on you for giving them advice. That's what makes it so bad. I don't even know what
yeah,
to do.
Yeah, it's a crazy time. Well, I tell you, I still walk in that lion's den. You know, I'll be on a few trains where I have a few young brothers. You know, I mean, young men are going to horseplay. Young men are going to, they do need space and energy. But when they conduct themselves in a way that they're causing an energy of either intimidation or an energy that they don't even want drawn to them. So I will still step to it. What I try to do is respectfully, because, you know, they don't want anybody telling them what to do, where they are. They think they have all the answers. So I'll come at them with that. And I respect, I say, young man, can I have a word with you? And I've usually had some pretty good, you know, even though I might start like, you know, what? Yeah, who? Huh? I like, you know what? I see you in me, young man. And all I want to do is share a little bit of the time that I've learned here to, that might help you later. And I can't think of a bad outcome I've had. Even if the brother was non-responsive, the energy still came back down. So I definitely don't want us to think that our young men, and even our young ladies, are unapproachable. But we do have to approach them with a level of respect that let's, okay, it's your time, but you still need guidance, young man, young lady. And if we can bond from there, I think that could be a good start of us reconnecting, because they need guidance.
And you're right about females. It's a big thing with female gangs now, too. They got the same attitude. It's sad. And what makes it bad, too, when they get locked up and go to the penitentiary, they're like at home with this nonsense. It makes it worse. It's not really disciplining them or showing them. They get up there and do the same thing. It becomes sometimes worse attitude with that. What makes this a dangerous situation to me, I don't see no remedy in this quite yet. Locking them up, I mean, you don't lock them up, but that's not a remedy. They growing up now to have this gang mentality, man. It's just sad. That's what makes it sad. I don't even see a remedy in this nonsense that they're doing, man. Really, to be honest.
Okay,
it's scary.
I accept that it's kind of bad, but we are the comeback people. I think we're going to pull out a win. We just got to stay committed. But, brother, again, thank you for sharing your words. And stay tuned. We're going to have some other insights and comments as we celebrate the life of a young man, unfortunately, that was taken from us too soon.
Yo, that was a baby, motherfucker. That was a baby.